Hey, this is Steve with Retro Tech, and welcome to this really short, quick talks. This is kind of an introduction episode to the episode coming out real soon about safety. I just needed to make some notes here that my videos are meant to just give you tips and practical, kind of layman terms, how to use your monitors, and basically what you can do to avoid any kind of shocks and injuries, but you're still doing these things at your own risk. I take no responsibility for anyone's, whatever might happen, whether you damage your device or do end up making a mistake and hurting yourself. I can't be responsible for that. I'm just trying to do this to help and introduce people to a lot of these techniques that can really prolong the life of your monitor, as well as make it a very enjoyable experience by having it set up correctly and knowing how to use them correctly. There is one thing I want to note, and I know this is kind of boring just looking at the back of this PVM, but the most common injury from PVMs is actually not related to electricity. It's related to lifting and back injuries, because a lot of these, especially 20-inch monitors and BVMs, weigh between 70 and 100 pounds. And if you don't know how to lift anything properly, you can hurt yourself. It can fall over. Another quick note, when you're working on anything that's electrical, you want to do what's called I'll move the camera over here to kind of where I can step in the scene here, but you want to use what's called the one-hand rule when you're working on something that's got live current. And that is, you're going to work with one hand, and you're going to keep your other hand in your pocket, or you can keep it behind your back, touching the back of your back, or in your pocket. And what that is that's a method to prevent you from accidentally touching and grounding out current and letting the current go through the middle of your body, which is the most dangerous electrical shock you could receive, is that direct current through the middle of your body. So if you have previous heart problems, it's not really advised that you should work on these or any other kind of serious health problems. And I've tried to research on deaths or anything, and I just keep finding nothing as confirmed from the electrical shock of these TVs. But perhaps someone who had a bad heart got shocked and died, and was considered a heart attack, or they might have gotten shocked and the shock could have made them fall backwards, hit their head on something, and they could have died from that, or a coma from that, or an infection from a cut from falling after being shocked. So that's the real threat. But please look at the next video where I kind of go over in detail what can fail and what can happen. You also need to make sure you inspect your PVM before you work on it, and just make sure that the quality of the components are still relatively good. You want to make sure you don't have any splits in your high voltage. Nothing compromised, no cracks. You want to make sure your cable still looks perfectly insulated, and that's really important. So thanks again for just checking this quick talks episode introducing the next episode about safety, and please comment and subscribe and look for future videos. Thank you.